I'm here at the Abyssinian Baptist Church, and this is Harlem Network News. I'm Terri Wisdom, and I would say, so goes Harlem, so goes the world. So goes the Abyssinian Baptist Church, and so goes the world. I'm here with one of our members and members of the choir. Just introduce yourself, say your name, and just say how you're feeling on this glorious morning here in Harlem.
Well, my name is Mari Moss. I am the mother of three growing Harlem girls. My eldest just graduated and will be going to high school. And this church means so much to our community. First of all, I want to say also to God be the glory, because that was the message today, was that whatever we do, we must do it to the glory of God. It's not for our own self-gain. It's not for our own purposes, our own, you know, grabbing for power or influence or recognition, but it's to the glory of God. So to God be the glory every time we think about this church. When we think about the history of this church, from Adam Clayton Powell Jr., who became the first Black elected in the community of Harlem, all the way to Reverend Calvin Otis Buss. But when I think about Reverend Hoggard, who gave so much these last 2 years to hold Abyssinian together, it's just, it's overwhelming to think about everything that he went through, everything that he did, and everything he did to make sure the stability of the church stayed together. So we have to continue to pray. We have to continue to seek God and make sure that we're doing what God's will is, because as Terri Wisdom said, as Abyssinian goes, so goes Harlem, and so goes the rest of the world. This is the international capital of... This is the international capital of the African-American diaspora,
right?
So it's very important that we do.
Yes, absolutely.
God.
And this is indeed the Mecca. And today, for the first time, we welcomed our new pastor in the person of Dr. Kevin.
Kevin R. Johnson.
Kevin R.
KRJ.
Okay.
Those initials are very familiar, but it's a Harlem.
Yes.
But yes, KRJ.
Okay.
So
yeah.
We're looking forward to seeing what he can do, what he will bring.
Right.
He has a family. He's definitely involved, been involved in the Harlem community under the tutelage of Reverend Calvin Otis Buss III. So we shall see what will come about.
Right. And as we stand in Harlem, as we stand with our public officials, the next president and our next pastor, we are the church, we are the body, and we plan to hold our pastors and our public officials accountable.
We must. That's important, and that's one thing Adam Clayton Powell Jr. did emphatically, was he held everybody accountable, and he spoke truth to power every time. And not only that, but he got results. So if we follow in the same fashion as someone who built the stability and made Abyssinian the power seat of Harlem, Adam Clayton Powell Jr., we need to do that. Make sure that we hold our elected officials accountable, our pastors accountable, and make sure that they're doing what's right according to the will of God.
Okay, well, thank you, Mari.
Right,
great interview, and forward ever, backward never, in the words of Marcus Messiah Garvey.
Yes.
And
yes,
it takes a village.
It does.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Thank you. Identify yourself, give us your title, and tell us why you're here and what's happening here in Harlem at Abyssinia Baptist Church, one of the Meccas.
Hi, I'm Michael J. Garner. I'm the most immediate past president of the 100 Black Men of New York, the founding chapter. In addition to being the chief business diversity officer for the city of New York under Mayor Eric Adams, I'm here at the great Abyssinian Baptist Church to witness the transition, but also to support Reverend Hoggard, who for the past 2.5 years has done an outstanding job of keeping this congregation together and this dynamic historical institution together. So I'm here to congratulate him and to thank him for his great service, and also witness the transition from one pastor to another pastor at the great historical Abyssinian Baptist Church. Thank you.
Okay, well, thank you. And so goes Harlem, so goes the world, so goes Abyssinian.
Absolutely.
So goes Harlem.
You got it.
So we're very appreciative for that. Thank you. I'm Terri Wisdom, and this is Harlem Network News, and we are right here at the new Abbey West. Really, it's my first time, and it's amazing. We're having a little reception for our new minister, and that's Dr. Reverend Kevin Johnson. So we are very, very, very grateful. KRJ and the congregation is here. Reverend Hoggard, who has held it down for the past 2 years, basically gave a good closing address. And I continue to say, so goes Harlem, so goes the world, so goes Abyssinian, and so goes Harlem. So we stand firm. There is change, but it's not what happens, it's what you do with it. So let's move forward. Forward ever, backward never, and power to the people, we the people. Let us hold all of our public officials, our clergy, accountable to do the work. Thank you.
Just introduce yourself, okay. A few words, yeah. And what this experience okay. is as we make Harlem history ready. And Abyssinian history. Okay.
My name is Kevin Johnson. I'm beyond thankful to God to be the 21st pastor of the Abyssinian Baptist Church. It's going to be one abbey, one church, and I'm excited about being back here in Harlem. Join us here at Abyssinian on Sundays at 10 a.m.
Okay, thank you. And this is Harlem Network News, and we're right here in the building. So thank you. Okay.
Thank you.
So just identify yourself and share what's happening in our historic.
Hey, Harlem. Hi, everybody. I'm Tiffany Ellis Butts coming to you live from the Abyssinian Baptist Church from Abbey West. We're here celebrating the wonderful work of Reverend Rashaad Hoggard, who has been so significant and important to holding together the Abyssinian community for the last 2.5 years, maintaining Reverend Butts' legacy through his transition, and now as our new senior pastor has arrived. So it's just a wonderful day, and just seeing all around and hearing all the buzz and enjoying the cake and enjoying Reverend Hoggard's face on the cake. We are all here with Miss Terri, and we're loving it, Harlem, and we hope to see you at Abyssinian soon. One abbey, one church.
Okay, one Harlem.
That's right, one Harlem.
Thank you. Okay, just identify yourself.
I'm Basil Patterson, and I've been attending the worship experience at Abyssinian for a while now. I had originally come to Abyssinian when I was much younger, but I attended Vacation Bible School. And then I joined the worship experience in middle school, closer to high school. It's just been so rewarding to be able to have such deep insights on spiritual guidance, but also contemporary topics, that's conversation that arises in the high school group. It's just been very insightful, very crucial to my growth as a young adult and a scholar. And I'm always appreciative of my experience at Abyssinian.
Okay, well, thank you for your service, and we're here a big time and transition in Abyssinian, Harlem as well. So how do you feel?
I feel great.
Okay, excellent. Thank you. By yourself, and just share what you have to say here at the Abyssinian Baptist Church about Reverend Hoggard transition.
My name's Daniel Patterson, and I just wanted to express that Reverend Hoggard has held up Abyssinian and the Abyssinian family through a lot over the past 2.5 years. He's reached out to HBCUs, he's reached out to other educational institutions, elected officials, local groups that support the community, as well as religious groups, and he preaches. It's just touches your heart, the manner in which that he follows Christ, the Lord, and his moral turpitude of talking about how the world should be with God. Thank you so much.
Okay, well, thank you, and it's a new day, and God is in charge, and we, the congregation, are accountable and holding all accountable. And this is Harlem Network News. I'm Terri Wisdom. Thank you
for coming to this reception for Dr. Hoggard. I know that many of you have cards and expressions of love, but we want to give now the man of the hour an opportunity to speak to everybody, Reverend Dr. Rashaad Hoggard. Yeah.
Thank you all so much. Was not looking or expecting any of this. Thank you. Enjoy the cake. It's been a blessing to be here 20 years and to serve Abyssinian. You all are wonderful. Thank you so much, Dr. Johnson, for this. Very much appreciative, and to all the officers who helped to put this together. Know that I love Abyssinian Church abundantly, and it is inextricably linked to who I am. And so I'm just grateful to be a part of this church and its forward progress. So thank you so much. Look forward to seeing all of you next week. Okay.
Okay, thank you. All right.